Hey guys, this is just going to be a quick episode. We just finished watching this movie, and I, you know, had to absolutely talk about it. Thought it was awesome. So I'm just going to do a good, a bad, and unusual, like normal. We got for our good, Hank and Mike. Now, it looks pretty stupid, I know, but it's absolutely not. It's very, very cool. It's about these two Easter bunnies who work for this organization. All the Easter bunnies work for this one, like, central organization. Well, these two acts, they forget a house, or they miss one house, and the customers call up and complain, and these two Easter bunnies get fired. Now, throughout the whole movie, they're wearing these Easter bunny costumes, and everyone takes it completely serious. Everyone sees them and just knows, oh yeah, they're Easter bunnies, which I think is absolutely hilarious. Reminded me of, like, Executive Koala or the Calamari Wrestler, if you guys have seen either one of those. It's a bit like that. Basically, they get fired. All their Easter Bunny friends, you know, don't get along with them anymore. There's a little bit of a love story going on as well between one of them. One is like a complete badass rebel with a bad attitude. The other one is a slightly overweight, socially awkward one. And anyway, they go to unemployment and they get like all these jobs and they keep getting, you know, let go from them. Very funny movie. Highly recommended. It's released by Magnet here in the States, so, you know, it's very easy to find. It's very, very cheap, too. It's not for children, though. Absolutely not a kid's movie. It has lots of nudity, sex, violence, drug use, drinking, bad language, everything you can think of that an Easter Bunny should not do, they definitely do. And there's the disc art for you. Again, very cool movie. Absolutely recommend it. Now for my bad, this one was quite a disappointment here. We got Batty, or the Turkish E.T. is what it's more known as. This is a bootleg. There's no release for this film. This is a rip of a Turkish VHS, so the quality's quite poor. It's exactly what the Turkish E.T. It's a Turkish remake of E.T. The story's a little bit different, and it rips off things like Star Trek. It's got the Enterprise as one of the spaceships in the movie and a bunch of old 50s sci-fi flicks. They often steal stuff for the old Turkish remakes. But E.T. in this one is not a nice, friendly alien. He's a badass with fucking demon teeth, and he's quite evil, I think. Now, there's no subtitles on this, so you can kind of just make up what you want as it goes along. And it's a lot of fun, but it's absolutely a horrible movie. So that's Batty. I'll try and find a trailer, actually, and stick it on this video, because it's hilarious. But the quality is just so poor that it's hard to really, really enjoy it. I think that if it got a release one day, and even with English subtitles, it would be even funnier. Now, lastly, I don't know if I've shown this before or not, but I finally actually watched the movie. So even if I have shown it before, I'll actually have a chance to talk about the movie now. And this is the Eyecatcher small hard box for Chud 2. Chud 2, I don't believe, is released in the United States. At least I've never seen it if it is. I think there is a European release, but I decided to pick up this hard box for it. I believe it's limited to 1,000. Yeah, just 1,000. This is the second cover, which I actually like more than the original cover, which you can see here on the disc art. It has the original cover for the movie. So, you might have seen that one. Anyway, the movie is absolutely nothing like the first Chud. In the first Chud, there's these, you know, cannibalistic humanoid underground dwellers under New York City's subway, sewer, you know, and they eat a few people. There's not a whole lot of them, and there's not a whole lot of action, really, but it's still a pretty good watch. Well, the second one is more like a zombie flick. The government has actually created these Chuds, and they're still working on them when one gets kind of loose or free, and it wakes up, and it never goes underground, and there's absolutely no blood in this movie. I was very, very surprised. There's like zero blood throughout the whole movie. But there's actually a lot more of the Chuds. This one ends up infecting a whole town, and it's a lot like a zombie movie. They're blue, they walk around, and they just eat people. And after they eat them, they just kind of bite on them, and then they leave them, and then they get up, and they're Chuds also. So it's a lot like zombie flicks. It's a lot like a zombie flick. But it's fun. It's just like a typical 80s fun flick. I honestly don't know when this was released, though. It might have been early 90s. But it's really weird to see a horror movie that I enjoyed that's cheesy and has no blood. That's the astonishing thing there. And it's more like a zombie flick, like I said. The whole town's infected. They end up kind of boarding off or surviving in this one little building. And then near the end, there's a nice little twist ending, a little happy feel-good 80s twist ending. But it's cool. It's definitely a must-see if you enjoyed the first one. That's it for me, guys. I hope you enjoyed my good, my bad, and my unusual choice for today. All right, take it easy, guys. Have a good one.